Hello and welcome to the internet. My name is Jake Dragon 7 and welcome to today's episode of Smash Squad. So yeah, I haven't done one of these in a little while, but mostly because it happened was I went to a my first Smash 4 tournament recently, so I ended up spending a lot of time just practicing for that and kind of putting Smash Squad to the side. And then I was just on vacation for a week, so I wasn't really able to record there. But yeah, now I'm finally back and I'm ready to play some Smash. Actually make episodes of Smash Squad for the first time in a while. So, today, we're going to be taking on some characters from the Mario series, those specifically being Mario, Rosalina, and Bowser Jr. So Bowser Jr. is the only one of these I've played before, I think. And I actually timed this episode to be this particular video because of, if you remember, for the fifth episode of the series, it had characters that are from the Mario universe but aren't considered as part of the Mario series in Smash. So I decided, why not, ten episodes later, I do the exact opposite thing and just play characters from the Mario series. Well, not the exact opposite, but something similar. So kind of like a callback to my fifth episode of sorts. It's a little thing I thought I might try to do. Yeah. So, I'm going to be starting off with Mario. He's probably my best out of the three. I mean, he is by far the easiest out of the three to play. He's one of the easiest characters in the game, really. It's not too difficult to really know what you're doing with Mario. So yeah, we have Mario versus Bowser. This is a, I feel like this is a very Mario-oriented matchup. With canonically, and oh my god, the lag. Holy, this. This is some of the worst lag I've ever played in. Oh, my, what the fuck? This is how I come back. I come back to this. Of all the things I could have come back to when recording Smash Squad, it's this. It's this. I can't even see. I can see, like, my pant leg and, like, parts of my boots. I'm just inside Bowser's stomach. It's actually really morbid. What am I even talking? Yeah, so let's just say we all know where I am. Oh, never mind. Well, there's a connection error. Good. I was just going to kill myself anyway, so yeah. It's very pleasant. No, not with friends. I don't have any friends. Couldn't play with friends. Jokes so obvious. It's like, what am I even making? Yeah, they're obvious. And I want to throw in something to make you guys chuckle a little bit. And hey, look at that. I'm fighting another guy named... Wait, but his name's Max. His mean name is Max. So this is a strange situation indeed. And I was checking my audio, so I just ran past the other Mario and started jabbing. That's a great gameplay right there. Okay, so you have a Zelda. The matchup I feel is kind of good for Mario, but I mean, it's not like a huge deal. So as many of you know, I do sometimes play Dr. Mario. From here on out, since I plan to start going to some tournaments soon, I've kind of started playing as him less so I can focus more of my efforts on my actual mains, which are now stuck on Silk, in case you're new to the channel. Or you forgot, in which case, how could you? Oh, that did not work. But yeah, so I do have quite a bit of experience playing Doc, but of course, that doesn't just mean that I'm going to be able to play Mario perfectly just because I played Doc. There are quite a few differences between the two characters. Just like the way they use their fair can be a bit different. Mario's is, you know, for spikes, of course, and Doc's is just heavy powerhouse type of move. Of course, Mario also moves a lot faster and just has more combos, so a lot of my combos, sometimes I'll just try to do Doc combos and playing as Mario, which tends not to work out too well, and oh god, that was actually really smart. It's also really smart too, because apparently the, teleport specials have invulnerability, or like invincibility, or whatever you call it, when they grab the ledge, if you're above it. Be used to mash, dudes. Yeah. So, anyway. Yeah. Basically, Mario. Ooh. I've actually done that before. I've gotten like a double spike. It should have been in the last episode of Stadium Chronicles. I got like a double spike on a Ganondorf. Let's see if that can work. No, okay, maybe not. We are pretty neck and neck here. Okay, well, I took it. Oh god. I was like sliding for a second. I'm like, wait, I gotta steal this. I gotta steal this game. So yeah, so far, I kind of got the match. But I mean, again, Mario is a very easy character. And he's also a very good character. So it's kind of like, definitely gotta have some form of matchup strength here. I can definitely say from playing Doc that the bear for the Mario has become one of my most loved. Oh crap! I didn't think that was gonna reach me. But yeah, I definitely come to really like the bear for the Mars, because I feel like it is one of Doc's best moves, because of how fast it comes out. It's got like a pretty strong move. Just a little. See if I can get. Nah, not quite. Oh, come on. I tried B reversing that, but it did not work out. Okay. Of course, unlike Doc's, Mario is not super good for killing unless you're right near. Oh, shit. Oh, what the f. Oh, my God. I can't. Wait, I was at like 20. Wait. Okay, I just looked at my footage because my capture card's like lagging behind a lot right now. I was at 19! Oh my God! What? Are you serious? What? I'm going right away now. What? No. Oh my God. Do not sleep on Raid Zelda. Well, no, because it was like a combination of like Zelda with a ton of rage, one of her best kill moves, and the fact that I was charging a smash attack, which makes you lighter. Like, all the, like, I died at 19! And, like, I know I was close to the ledge, but I wasn't at the ledge. I was, like, I mean, there was some space between me and the ledge. Alright, though, so Rosalina, now I will say this up front, I do kind of feel bad at doing this, because I know, I admittedly do like playing as Rosalina. I think she's a fun character, but, oh my God, she's good. She's so good, and she's one of those characters, especially like as a Nesmi, as I mentioned earlier. I just hate playing against Rosalina, because, like, probably Ness's worst matchup right there, and I mean, very few characters really give Ness difficulty, so when you end up fighting a character that does, it just is a bit frustrating. Struggles of playing a top tier, and there's, like, no one that can beat you, but then you absolutely despise fighting the people that do beat you. But yeah, so like I said, I do find Rosalina to be very fun, but I also just feel really bad when playing against, not against her. No, I just get irritated when I play against her. I just feel bad when I play as her, because I know, like, I have a feeling the other person's just not having that much fun. But yeah, so Rosalina, of course, you know, Luma, shenanigans. I honestly just really think it's a fun system. Like, sometimes you can just do some really weird combos or just set up to some really stupid stuff with Rosalina. I think it's fun. I do personally think it's very fun. And stuff like that, only with a character like Rosalina could that seem like an even remotely smart strategy. Now, I will admit that forward smash I threw out when I started mentioning that, it wasn't a good forward smash, but still, like, you get what I mean. You know, Rosalina can do some very odd things with Luma. And it can be very, very fun to try to, like, figure out how to control Luma and, like, utilize Luma. It's very interesting. It's very fun. But, again, I know Rosalina is just so good, and I know I personally absolutely detest this character. She might just be my most hated character. Oh, God. Oh, man. At first, I'm like, okay. Because the problem is that is Ganondorf's reversal is so slow. Because, like, Falcon's would have been a lot faster. So I wouldn't have fallen into that trap. Luckily, I did roll early enough to the point where I could have actually perfect shielded that. And yeah, so I got a fairly early kill. Actually, what percent was he at? He was only at 61. We're getting a lot of early kills this video. Now, his character, well, I guess Rosalina's got a lot of early kills because of stupid Luma shenanigans. And I guess I will fight this guy again, give him a nice sort of fair match. Yeah, I mean, my Bowser Jr. is just awful. I'm just gonna say that right here. I did play Bowser Jr. in the Villains episode. And that was actually really close to the beginning of the series. But yeah, I played Bowser Jr. in that video, and honestly, I've gotten like, because I barely played this character since then, and it's just like, Bowser Jr. is just another really weird character. But he's not like good weird, like, or like weird in a way that makes him a really good character like Rosalina. He's just like, I don't hate Bowser Jr. I actually quite enjoy playing as him. I'm just god awful at him. I tend to get really spammy with, like, my side B and up B and, like, my smashes, because they're strong, I guess. I don't know. I can't really explain it, but I feel like I'm using all the moves I shouldn't be and not using all the moves I really should be. So, yeah, don't expect me to do well. As you can see, I'm losing to this guy's Link really bad right now. I'm gonna try to catch him at the up air. I'd say Junior's up air is one of his best moves. Of course, I'm not actually playing as Bowser Jr. right now. I'm technically playing as Iggy, but, oh my God. Oh my God. This episode has been one of the stupidest episodes so far. I swear. So much stupid stuff has been happening here. It's just like... This is not supposed to be a thing, yeah. I don't even know, I'm just like... reveling in how weird this episode's been. Okay, is that gonna... not quite. Imagine his forward smash can kill kind of early, I think, but I don't know, I mean... I feel like it would be a lot, like, I feel like it always kills a lot later than I expect it to. Right. Him with the fork. Dinner utensils, the most, or silverware, whatever you want to call it. The most dangerous weapon in the world, of course. Only in a game like Smash would you find something that, well, not really, but... Oh. Smash Bros. Is one of the only, like, big fighting games you'd fight something that odd. Or, like, something stupid like that. I don't know. Okay. Yeah, I am one of those people that goes for a lot of, upbeat games, because it's just kind of easy. And, I don't know, I like it. It's fun. And I think that maybe... No, not quite. Okay. I was actually looking out for an up air right there. Yeah, I figured he was going to go for up air and not up special, not spin attack, but... Let's see, I got him with the dare. And no, not quite. And you know, he didn't actually have to shield that. I mean, Link can block projectiles without even shielding. Oh. Yeah, as you can tell, as soon as I kind of, like, noticed where our positions were, I... Oh, shite. Didn't expect that to happen, although I probably should have. Well, this episode has, not been going all that well. Let's put it that way. I guess it's been going okay. So, wait, Yeah, lost is more... Oh, I didn't mean to do this again. Well, okay, here we go. We're fighting him again with Bowser Jr. So I lost as Mario for the dumbest reason possible. I won as Rosalina. And then I lost as Bowser Jr. Because of course I did. Okay. Let's try this again. Maybe I can at least come closer to winning. Alright, he's going Roy. I think this is the last time we're going to fight this person. Unless, like, oh god, there's lag. But yeah, it's probably going to be the last time I fight this person. Unless I get trigger happy with the start button again. Well, so far, of course, it's about as bad as I thought it was going to be. Yeah, it's going about as well as I expected it to. That is to say, it's going terribly. This is awful. Okay, finally, I actually got a hit on him. With down B, just mix-ups, I guess. I don't know. It's not like I even really... Like, I don't know. It's kind of like the luckiest loser I'm really trying to say here. Oh my god, it's been a while since I recorded. Like, the last thing I recorded was, Shovel Knight episodes 4 through 6. And that was, I'm pretty sure, before the third episode was recorded, uploaded, so. I recorded episodes 4 through 6 before I recorded episode 3, of course, that's how... Because that's how the series works. Okay, well, oh my god. I should have done that way earlier. I do seem to have a tendency to do that. Like, I'll try to run in and punish Smash. Oh, okay, good. It only counted as the first hit, which is pretty weak. Oh god. And then he killed me with a tipper on that. That's like such an unsatisfying way to die by Roy's tipper. Cause, like, just listen to the sound effect for it. It's just like... Like, that's just... it's so unsatisfying to die by hearing that. Okay, well... Let's see here, maybe that'll... Okay. He's down. Alright, well, it's about even here. Oh, God. You see it on the starting platform a lot longer than I thought he would. Interesting. Okay, though, wait, what was he even saying? Oh, but yeah, so, anyway, yeah, I haven't recorded in a while, so I'm kind of, like, I don't know, getting back into it. Okay. Just seeing if I can bring this back somehow. I'm doing a lot better than I did. Oh god. Oh, I almost ran right into that. Yeah, I'm doing a lot better than I did last match, and really the beginning of this match, too. Yeah, because I let him get, like, I think, like, about 80% on me at the beginning of the match. And now I'm ahead of him, actually. So, yeah. Good on me here. And that was a combo. Okay, see if I can... Yuppie Gimp. And I'm sorry I have to do this, but, yeah, that's it. I'm gonna make an attack. Okay, I took it. Yay! Alright, so we're going to go up against someone else this time around, and we are going to try Mario again, because I did win with Rosalina. And I got the... I can't believe... I still can't believe I lost as Mario. I was, like, 100% ahead. Like... Okay, well, let's just get started here. Alright, nice Mario got. I think it's like frame 2 or 3 now, so that's pretty good. Yeah, I think it's 3. Yeah, one thing I try to do as Mario, just to seem like less of a jerk, is if I ever do like an upstring, up tilt string, I'll only do it like once or twice, and I'll just do like an up smash, because it's just one of those combos, it's like, I mean, yeah, obviously, if you're trying to win, go for it, but it's like, it's just so not fun to deal with, it's just like one of the most lame things ever. So this is one of those things I do try to avoid when playing as Mario. I'll usually do like down throw and then up air, up tilt like once or twice. And sometimes I'll also like, I don't really do this too often anymore, but when I first started practicing as Mario for this episode, this is something I did a lot. I would, with Dr. Mario, I do, down throw up air and not down throw up tilt. So sometimes when I'm playing as Mario, I would go for down throw up air instead of up tilt and miss my easy combo. Okay, let's get the flood charged up here. So we can get going here. Alright. He almost got me with that up smash. But, still living. Oh, me. Yeah, okay. I'm trying to go for down throw up air right now. And nice try with that up smash, but it's not gonna work because I got my forward smash, so. I actually think I might be really close to killing him with my up smash. Unless I die. I'm only saying that because I have rage. So if I die, I probably will not. Nice. Alright, got 2 stock with Mario. Feeling pretty good about that. Yeah, I guess I'll go on to someone else. Because I did fight that first guy like 4 times, so. Let's try to get a bit more variety. Alright, we got the Captain Falcon here. Not very surprising, 4 glory, of course, you know, 4 Falcons. Yeah, it's definitely feeling like now. The other thing too, when I was on vacation, there was no Wi-Fi in the room I was staying at. And if you're wondering how I survived, I barely did. I just played a lot of Pokken and Hyrule Warriors. A little bit of Kirby and Metroid, so. Yeah, games that don't require Wi-Fi to actually play. I didn't really play that much Smash, because there was no one there that played Smash, and I don't like playing Smash against computers. Like, I'm trying to get into Pokken right now, actually. I might go to a few, at the Smash training I go to, there are some Pokken tournaments, so I might go to one or two at some point. I don't know. I'm still thinking about it, but, like, I'm just learning the game right now, so it's like... Oh, crap. That was bad. But yeah, so, like, I'm going to their, a Smash Weekly next week. I plan on it anyway. It'll actually be done by the time this is uploaded. But yeah, but I'm probably not going to go to their Pokken ones for a while. Really depends. If you're curious, I mean Weavile in Pokken, because Weavile is my favorite Pokemon, so it's kind of just like, you know, of course, who else but, that was dumb. Bye, Luma. But yeah, I mean, who else am I going to play aside from, you know, my favorite mon, right? So, anyway, okay, so this match, not going too well for me so far. Pretty decent Falcon player right here. Doesn't help that my Rosa is not that good, honestly. It's not bad by any means, but it's not like the best. Oh my god. I thought there was going to be a little bit more range on that. I feel like the fact that Luma can, like, sometimes, because especially, like, someone who doesn't even main her is just kind of playing her for fun right now. It's like, I don't really know the specifics of how Luma actually works. So it's kind of just like... it almost seems like her Rose's forward smash range is like completely random just based off what Luma wants to do. Okay, looks like I got him with Luma right there. Okay, so I'm at a 51% back, and looks like, no, Luma's still living. Huh. Kind of had a feeling Luma's gonna be gone by now. God damn. If I had gone for to attack him in the left, not upwards, I would have gotten it. And Luma is still alive, wow. I know Luma has like 50% HP, but I feel like Falcon would have been able to deal that by now. Okay, that's it for Luma. Anything, I should probably be trying to just stay back right now, but I really just want to get the damage on Falcon. I'm starting to get... Honestly, I think I'm starting to get a bit greedy here. Okay. Gonna have to use Luma as a bit of a meat shield right now, I guess. And like I said, Luma does a 50 HP. It's a decent amount, though. I'm just kind of worried the Falcon could take that really quickly, especially. He does have rage now. I mean, it's not a lot of rage, but... Obviously, it does make him a bit more of a threat. And now I lost Luma again, so... Oh, God. Oh, Rosalina, why is your recovery? How could this happen to me? Oh, boy. Okay, I think I may go back to Mario, and then I'll probably do Junior, Rosa, and I guess that'll be it. I don't know, we'll see what happens. But yeah, then I'll give this guy a shot with my Mario. Let's do this weird color. Okay, so I'm assuming he's just gonna go Falcon again. I mean, he could have switched, but I think he... Yeah, okay, he's just saying Falcon. Figured as much. Let's go. Just try to get some, little zoning in with the fireballs here. Okay. Kind of hoping I just get lucky there. And yeah, we're just kind of not hitting. Well, okay, now we're hitting each other, but it was a pretty long string of not hitting each other. Basically, nothing happening. Ooh, drop shield. Alright, see ya, he's coming back. Okay, right now we're actually, for a second I thought we were even, but apparently not, I was actually behind. Oh no, oh my god. Okay, why does it seem like, I feel like this is one of the only times I've really noticed this happening. I feel like I'm taking so much more knockback than usual when I did with like that smash attack effect, where it's like you have more knockback if you're charging a smash. And maybe it's because I've never been hit with such powerful moves while charging a smash, but I feel like that's been the effect has been like multiplied since. Like, it's like a multiply. I don't know why, but like, oh god. Well, this match started out even. I mean, I took a stock, but I'm at 77%, and well, you saw what happened to me last time. I could potentially, yeah, I could potentially die now. Anyway, like, seriously, that effect seems to have been multiplied since I last played, or like, just from Mario. I don't know why, but like, I feel like I should at least be surviving an extra 10 or 20%. And there we go with my down throw up airs. Oh, god. Well, let's just say, at least I wasn't charging a smash, right? Like, seriously, I died like 30... Oh, god. I mean, okay, rage may have been a part of it, but I died like 30% earlier. And I survived that time when I got hit by the Raptor Beast. So it's... I mean, I guess DI could have also been a part of it, because I could have DI'd that better, but still... I don't know, this entire thing is weird and sketchy, and I don't like it, so let's go fight someone with Bowser Jr. and see if that happens to work out, which it probably won't, because like I said, my Bowser Jr. is terrible. Okay, now we're actually fighting a Mario. I'm coming in strong with Roy, the boy, our boy. He's just a boy. I don't know. Can't. Okay, not thinking of anything that rhymes with boy. You'd think there'd be so many things that rhyme with it. Okay, yeah, toy, koi, the doy, I don't know. Oh! I don't think I had a second jump there. I don't think I had a second jump. But, even if I did, I didn't use it. God. Well, this is not going well. This guy's literally just comboing me with up smash. I mean... Okay. Just trying to see if this will work out for me at all. Oh god. Grab release. Okay. Let's see. Okay, that should be enough to kill. Yeah, okay. Just barely got it. Oh boy. Yes! Okay. I was gonna say like, oh man, I'm bringing it back, but I didn't want to jinx it. I didn't want to, commentator's curse or whatever. So it's like, oh yes, I brought it back though. That was so awesome. You know, I did really poorly in the beginning, but at the end, I started getting some pretty decent combos. It's kind of the theme of the series, in case you didn't already know. Pretty decent combos. Alright, I guess, yeah, we're in like 30 minutes now, so we'll do one more match with Rosalina. And see what happens here. I think I lost with Mario, so I have a 2-1 record with Junior. I won 2, lost 1 with Junior. I believe with Rosalina, I won 1 and lost 1, and then Mario lost 2-1-1. Okay. Very weird to say 1-1. Lost 2. Okay, whatever. I'll stop because it's probably annoying. Alright, though, so. Got Mario versus Rosalina. We're actually on a Mario stage. Wait, this is the Rainbow Road music. Couldn't be much more fitting for a character like Rosalina. The space themed and all. I don't really think I needed to point that out, but... You know, I felt the need to. I mean, sometimes you just feel the need to explain things because you get paranoid that nobody's ever going to understand what you're saying. And no one will ever love you, and you'll never have any friends. Sad face. And Rosalina's up air is very stupid. Although, honestly, I mean, shouldn't really be too mad about that, because I do mean Ness. Ness hasn't... Oh, God. I'm for the spike myself, but I almost got spiked by him. But yeah, I mean, I really shouldn't be complaining about Ruse's up air, because I play Ness, and he's another character with a stupid up air. Although, I think we can all agree, Cloud has by far the dumbest up air in the game. I mean, come on, that thing stays out for so long. It's, like, impossible to air dodge that. Oh, God. Oh, jeez. Don't tell me I'm dead here. And that... Oh, my God, the fair killed me. That was an interesting rage noise. Okay. So, yes. And yes, that is by far the dumbest thing Rosalina can do, in my opinion. Cancel grabs. Like, cause grab releases to happen. This is admittedly one thing I hate with Rosalina. Like, I mean, obviously, it's fun to deal with her, and it's a super effective move, but it's like... Oh, that doesn't change the fact that it's super annoying to fight against. Like using Luma to cancel other people grabbing you is just... And again, especially, I hate to bring this back, but, like, the fact that I'm a Ness main, I, like, kind of live and die off of grabs a lot of the time, so it's, like, fighting Rosalina, the two most annoying things are getting so, having pretty much my PK fire entirely shut down by gravitational pull and, like, Luma just being able to block it and stop combos from happening, and then when I do get a grab, Luma just can't, like, hitting me out of the grab. So frustrating. Luckily, I still have my trusty up air, so, and other things like that. And while it's in a good match, this would never really happen. I always do also have PK Thunder 2 to support me in my darkest hours of playing Rosalina, or playing against Rosalina. Again, I do kind of like playing as Rosalina. I think she's a fun character with some... I think she is a legitimately very fun character. And got the air dodge read. Okay. There's one thing I've actually noticed that I'm pretty good at recently. I've been pretty good at reading air dodges. Again, another thing, just being an S player, it's kind of important, especially because, like, all three of the characters I play have really strong up airs. I mean, like, Shulk's isn't that useful in most matches because of how slow it is, so it's kind of, like, if you're going to utilize it, you got to be kind of, like, tricky when you use it. But, like, Duck Hunt and Ness, it's, like, they're pretty much some of their best kill moves, so. Especially Duck Hunt, because he has, like, no really good kill moves, so up air is an absolute godsend. Alright though, so I hope you guys all enjoyed this episode of Smash Squad. I know it's, in case you haven't looked to have the series back, you know, here you go. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed, maybe leave a like, a comment, maybe subscribe, I would appreciate it. And yeah, if you have any suggestions for future theme, leave them down in the comments below. It can just be any three characters, as long as there's something tying them together, whether it be, you know, series, playstyle, whatever, I don't really give a crap. Yeah, so hopefully I'll see you guys again in the future, and yeah, bye.